Hello everyone, how you are doing today? I hope you're having a great day. If you're new here, I'm Latifah and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today's video is a short video on how to perform a venipuncture. I actually wanted to film this video while I was performing a live drill on one of my classmates, but I was not allowed to do that in class, so I had to use the dummy arm. It's the same procedure. The difference is just that I'm using a dummy arm instead of a real person. You have to go through every steps like you're performing the venipuncture on a real person. Another thing is you have to pass your dummy arm competency before you can perform a live draw, that you are comfortable drawing blood from the dummy arm before you can move to a real person. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel, and if you do so, let me know in the comment section by leaving me a comment saying just subscribe. The first thing you want to do when you get into the room with a patient is introduce yourself. Like, hello, my name is Latifah. I'm an ABC phlebotomy student and I'll be drawing your blood today. Is that okay with you? You want to make sure you ask them if it's okay with them for you to go ahead and perform the phlebotomy procedure. And the reason is because you do not want to touch a patient who refuses to have their blood drawn. You can be charged with assault. So you want to make sure you ask them, oh, I'll be performing this procedure. Is it okay for me to go ahead? If they refuse, you can go to your supervisor and let them know that this person or this patient has refused to allow you to draw their blood. They might probably come in and talk to them, and if they still refuse, then there is nothing you can do. They'll have to call the doctor's office and let them know that the patient doesn't want their blood drawn. So once they give you a response saying yes, then the next thing is to ask for their full name with date of birth. And you can also confirm by asking them to spell either their first name or last name. And this is because some patients have similar names or similar pronunciation. You want to make sure you have the right person. Next question you want to ask the patient is about their blood draw history. Some patients have history of fainting during blood collection. This is something that you want to be aware of so that you can prepare yourself in case the patient actually faints. So the things you can do prior to blood collection is having the patient lay on the bed or have them sit in the recliner so that you can be prepared to catch or break the fall in case the patient actually faints. Another thing that you have to have at the back of your mind is if a patient faints, the first thing you have to do is immediately release the tourniquet, remove the needle from the patient's arm, and activate the safety device. After obtaining all this information, then we're ready to perform the phlebotomy procedure. Without wasting much of our time, let's get started. Here, I'm letting my patient know that I'm ready to tie the tourniquet, and I'll ask them to let me know if it's too tight. Also, you don't want to leave the tourniquet longer than a minute. I'll go ahead and palpate for a vein, and this is to find the vein and know the size and depth and also the direction of the vein. Then I'll go ahead with my alcohol pad to cleanse the site. You can see I'm going back and forth. While the alcohol is drying, I'll go ahead and assemble all my equipment. Here I am attaching my multi-sample needle into the hub. I'm using the BD Eclipse needle here. The safety device is attached to the needle. I'm arranging my tubes in the correct order of draw. I'll go ahead and tie my tourniquet. Make sure not to repalpate the site you cleansed earlier. Then I'll uncap my needle and quickly inspect for defect. While holding my hub between my thumb and fingers, I'll use my other end to anchor the vein by stretching the skin backward and insert the needle with the bevel facing up and at the correct angle. I'll go ahead and fill my tubes in the correct order of draw with the correct volume. And here I'm taking out the tube and I will insert the next tube. While that is filling up, I'll go ahead and invert my tube. Also, I'm stabilizing my needle by applying gentle but firm pressure to the patient's arm with the back of my fingers. And this will help during tube exchange to prevent movement of the needle in the vein. After inserting my last tube, I realized that I'm not getting any blood in the tube, so I went a little bit back and forth with the needle, and this is to reposition my needle into the vein. Sometimes you might pull back the needle when you are pulling out the tube, so you might have to go in a little bit forward to get back into the vein. And sometimes when you push the tube in, you might also push the needle out of the vein. So you want to pull back a little to reposition the bevel in the vein. I'll go ahead and take out my last tube, release my tourniquet, and take out my needle while putting pressure on the puncture site with the gauze. Activate my needle safety device and put it in the sharp container, while asking the patient to hold pressure on the puncture site. Also, you don't want to offer the patient a band-aid now, because we want to keep them for at least 3 to 5 minutes to make sure that they stop bleeding. So ask them to hold pressure while you label the tube. Invert your tube several times, and this is to mix the blood with the additives in the tube. Also, inspect the puncture site and make sure the patient stops bleeding. You can then go ahead and ask if they would like a band-aid. If yes, apply a band-aid on the puncture site. And if no, thank the patient and tell them they can leave. Thank you so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If this video has been helpful, make sure you give me a thumbs up, like, share, and don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in my next video. Bye.